Well, as the Citizenship Amendment Bill heads to the Rajya Sabha at noon tomorrow, we're joined now by Lok Sabha MP of the Congress Party, Manish Tewari, who took part in the debate in the Lok Sabha on Monday. Manish Tewari, despite the opposition's very strong opposition to this bill, it looks like the BJP is going to be able to get it through the Rajya Sabha tomorrow. Your thoughts?
Well, Nidhi, it would be extremely unfortunate because the numbers, the way they are stacked up in the Lok Sabha, obviously the bill would have gone through the Lok Sabha, and it did. But as you rightly pointed out, the opposition, the combined opposition, put up a very, very spirited fight. And I think everybody articulated their concerns fundamentally that extraterritorial or territorial religion cannot be the basis of granting citizenship. And I do hope that in the Rajya Sabha, where the numbers look better, some of the other parties would take a more enlightened view, because this bill hits at the very foundation of the Indian Constitution. It is in contravention of Article 14, Article 15, 21, 25 and 26. It is in contravention of the basic structure doctrine as articulated in Keshavanand Bharati, reaffirmed in the Bumai judgment and a catena of other judgments which followed subsequently. So therefore, what the government is doing is patently illegal, and yesterday they waxed eloquent about their concerns with regard to minorities, religious minorities and persecution in our neighboring countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, but today they did not bat an eyelid in taking away the rights of India's smallest minority, the Anglo-Indians, who had been given nomination going back to the commencement of the constitution in the Lok Sabha, 2 seats, and representation in 13 state assemblies across the country. And this has been done without consulting the states. And so therefore, this bill, which was being debated or is still being debated in the Lok Sabha today, you know, hits at the very foundation of federalism.
Well, Manish, before I come to more of the arguments that the BJP and the Home Minister have put forward in defense of the bill, just on the politics of it, now you have the Shiv Sena, which is your ally in Maharashtra now, that actually voted for this bill in the Lok Sabha, much to perhaps many who were surprised by it. But today Uddhav Thackeray says that, he's kind of hinted we may not necessarily do that in the Rajya Sabha. We still have, you know, certain questions that we have raised regarding this bill. Now, how do you reconcile, your alliance in Maharashtra with the Shiv Sena, with the position that the Shiv Sena has taken on this bill? They actually said that we voted for it in the Lok Sabha in national interest.
Well, Nidhi, the fact is that the ideological dissonance between the Congress, NCP on one side and the Shiv Sena on the other side is a given. You know, the Shiv Sena never asked us to give up our ideology, and I don't think it would be appropriate for us, you know, to really impose our own thinking on them. The fact is that the alliance in Maharashtra is the outcome of the situation that prevailed in that state. There was a need for a stable government, and there was a need to dispel this perception that irrespective of what the election results would be, the government in every state would be a BJP government. And so therefore, the Maharashtra experiment has really put a comma on this perception that the BJP had so assiduously cultivated by completely and absolutely in a unconstitutional manner toppling governments and cobbling together majorities. And we do hope after Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray's statement, the Shiv Sena would see the non-constitutionality, the inherent unconstitutionality of the Citizenship Amendment Bill and take a more enlightened view.
You're hoping they take a more enlightened view, but what do you think of the regional players who otherwise are not part of the NDA, like the BJD, for example, the AIADMK, technically not, but has supported the government a lot in the past? The fact that they have also sort of come out in such strong support of this bill, and that's what is actually helping the government's numbers in the Rajya Sabha as well, Manish Tewari. So what would you say to a Naveen Patnaik today who has chosen to support this bill?
Well, what I would say to Chief Minister Patnaik today is that there comes a time when you need to stand up and be counted. And Naveen Patnaik is an author, he's a progressive, forward-looking person, and I think there are certain issues which are above parties and politics, and citizenship, which forms the basis of a person's allegiance to the state, cannot be on religious grounds, especially when secularism is a part of the basic structure of our constitution. There is a need for Mr. Nitish Kumar, for Mr. Naveen Patnaik, and for the other regional players to rise above parties and politics and look at the long-term damage which amendment bills like the Citizen Amendment Bill are doing to the very constitution of India.
Would you give that advice to the Shiv Sena as well, that there comes a time when you have to be to stand up and be counted?
Well, I think the Shiv Sena, going by Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray's statement, you know, seems to be in a reconsideration mode. And I think everybody is looking at the fact that the bill as it stands constituted, passed in the Lok Sabha, you know, is in contravention of Article 14, 15, 21, 25, 26, the basic structure doctrine. It's a completely and patently unconstitutional bill, and I don't think anybody can or should close their eyes to it.
Finally, Manish Tewari, you're also a lawyer. And do you think this bill would hold up in the Supreme Court? And it's actually incredible that we have to ask this question today, because we have seen some of the orders, you know, in the judiciary lately, which have raised eyebrows, or non-orders. Actually, the judiciary hasn't often acted on basic fundamental freedoms and civil liberties, etc. So in that context, do you think that this bill would hold up in the Supreme Court, honestly?
Well, it is my fervent hope that the Supreme Court would uphold the Constitution of India. It would uphold the judgments that they have delivered in the past, especially the basic structure doctrine, which has stood us in good stead from 1973 onwards, because the entire argument of reasonable classification on which the Home Minister has pegged this entire bill is a completely superfluous argument. It's a flawed argument for the simple reason that reasonable classification rests on the principle that equals cannot be treated as unequals. And the moment a person applies for citizenship or comes to India, you know, and asks for asylum or asks to be admitted into the country because of religious persecution, you cannot discriminate between people of one faith or the other. You know, right. In and around India, you have the Ahmadiyyas, you have the Boras, you have the Shias, many other ethnic minorities, you know, who are being persecuted in the countries which have been named in the bill.
Yeah, what about the poor Tamils in Sri Lanka? Manish Tewari, thanks very much for joining us on the eve of that crucial debate in the Rajya Sabha. Thanks very much indeed.